Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ. Welcome to this live broadcast of the last papal event on what has been a very busy weekend for Pope Francis on his visit to Romania. My name is Father Paul Samasumo, and I'll be bringing you the live commentary of Pope Francis's visit and encounter with the Roma community in the Barbu Lătăru neighborhood of Blaj, here in Romania. On behalf of Vatican News, I'd like to welcome all of you who are joining us for this live broadcast from around the world. A special welcome to our television viewers of CBS News, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Net TV, and Catholic TV. Welcome to those of you joining us through various Vatican media channels, through the Vatican News web portal, Vatican Radio, or the Vatican News YouTube channel. We also have those of you that are joining us through the various radio stations of the world, as well as through various internet sources. The Pope is visiting this neighborhood, which is one of the oldest, and he's at a church which Cardinal Leonardo Sandri, Prefect of the Congregation for the Oriental Churches, blessed the foundation stone in 2017. According to a census of 2011 in Blaj, 9% of the inhabitants of this city belong to the Roma community. Pope Francis is coming as a pastor to this small Roma community of Greek Catholics. He comes to encourage them in their many challenges. The Greek Catholic Romanian Church in the city has been dealing with the pastoral care and social assistance of the Roma community over the years. The newly beatified martyr bishop, the Greek Catholic bishop and martyr, Ion Sushu, a native of Blaj, grew up among the Roma community, and as a bishop supported their community and promoted evangelization initiatives with young people, organizing, among other things, excursions and football matches. Pope Francis being welcomed there. Welcome, Pope Francis, to our community to show us a gift of love. Thank you for coming. The Pope is at this church. It's a newly built church which was only consecrated 2 weeks ago, on 19th May 2019. He has been received by a family.
Sfinte Părinte, bine ați venit în periferia periferiilor.
There's a testimony of a priest who belongs to the Roma community. Holy Father, welcome to the periphery of peripheries, here on the outskirts of Blaj, in the neighborhood of Babu Lătăru. We, the Roma, live here happily because the Romanian Greek Catholic Church has understood something important about us. We need to heal this fracture, this wound. It is important to meet these brothers and sisters out here to offer them the gospel of joy. We cannot fail to remember the newly blessed martyr bishop, Ioan Soșu, who joyfully played soccer with the small Roma boys right here on the streets where we find ourselves. It was an authentic fraternal spirit of friendship and sharing. The bishop paid with his own blood for his fidelity to Christ and now celebrates in the heavenly liturgy with the holy angels. We are grateful to our church for the pastoral care to the Roma, with various parishes dedicated to the spiritual accompaniment of families and their children. The temple in which we find ourselves here in our neighborhood is the concrete sign of this care, of the affection by the church towards us. I think I'm not wrong if I say that we are here to demonstrate how, in the Church of Christ, that there is always room for everyone. For this reason, the visit and the embrace that you, Holy Father, give to us today reveals to everyone what the true life of the Roma community is and how authentic their desire for inclusion and the need to participate in Romanian society and its activities and elsewhere to overcome discrimination and segregation. Thank you, Holy Father, for engaging in dialogue with time and for identifying your closeness to us as one of us. We welcome the Lord who came for the last, a love of the marginalized, the Lord who loved those who make us uncomfortable, those who are difficult to understand. For us and all the Roma people, your presence is a strong sign of encouragement and of hope. A very powerful testimony there from a priest who belongs to the Roma community in front of the Holy Father here in Blaj. It is no coincidence that the Holy Father is here. As you know, the Roma are said to be the largest minority in Europe. About 10 to 12 million of them live in Europe. Unfortunately, many of them are victims of prejudice and social exclusion, as you have heard from the priest. This happens not only here in Romania, but in other places where the Roma community live. And the prejudices go back many centuries. Therefore, it is no ordinary coincidence that Pope Francis is here. He always goes to the periphery, as we heard the priest say, welcome to the periphery of the peripheries, here on the outskirts of Blaj. And now Pope Francis's words. Dear brothers and sisters, good afternoon. I'm happy to meet you, and I thank you for your welcome. You, Father Johan, are quite right when you point to a truth as certain as is often forgotten. In Christ's Church, there is room for everyone. If it was not like this, it would not be a place, a church for Christ. The church is a place of encounter. We need to keep this in mind, not as a pretty slogan, but rather as a part of our identity card as Christians. You reminded us of this by recalling the example of the bishop and martyr, Ioan Sușu, who gave concrete expression to the desire of God, our Father, to encounter every person in friendship and in sharing. The gospel of joy is communicated in the joy and happiness of encounter and knowledge that we have a Father who loves us. Knowing that he watches out for us, we learn how to watch out for one another. In this spirit, I have wanted to shake hands with you, to look you in the eyes and open my heart to you in prayer and in the hope of becoming part of your own prayers and entering into your hearts. The translation there in Romanian.
Acea certitudine pe cât de sigură, pe atât de uitată adesea. În Biserica lui Hristos este loc pentru toți. Și dacă nu ar fi așa, nu ar mai fi Biserica lui Hristos. Biserica este loc de întâlnire și trebuie să ne amintim de acest lucru, nu ca un frumos slogan, dar ca făcând parte din cartea noastră de identitate, în calitate de creștini.
There are about 60 people in this small church, and outside, as you can see, another 250 outside. The Roma community has many parishes in this area.
Evanghelia bucuriei se transmite în bucuria întâlnirii, fiind conștienți că avem un tată care ne iubește. Priviți de el, înțelegem cum să ne privim între noi. Cu acest spirit am dorit să vă strâng mâinile, să vă privesc în ochi, să vă las să intrați în inima mea, în rugăciune, încrezător că voi avea și eu un loc în rugăciunea voastră și în inima voastră.
The Holy Father now is going to continue with his message to the Roma community. My heart, however, is heavy. It is weighed down by the many experiences of discrimination, segregation, and mistreatment experienced by your communities. History tells us that Christians too, including Catholics, are not strangers to such evil. I would like to ask you forgiveness for this. I ask forgiveness in the name of the Church and of the Lord, and I ask forgiveness of you for all those times in history when we have discriminated, mistreated, or looked askance at you with a look of Cain rather than that of Abel. We were unable to acknowledge you, to value you, and to defend you in your uniqueness. Cain was not concerned about his brother. Indifference breeds prejudices and fosters anger and resentment. How many times do we judge rashly with words that sting, with attitudes that sow hatred and division? Whenever anyone is left behind, the human family cannot move forward. We are not Christians, even human, if we cannot see the person before our own prejudices.
Este greutatea discriminărilor, a segregărilor și a maltratării suferite de comunitățile voastre. Istoria ne spune că nici creștinii, nici chiar catolicii, nu au fost străini de răul acesta atât de mare. Pentru aceasta, aș vrea să vă cer iertare. Cer iertare în numele Bisericii Domnului și vouă, pentru momentele când, în decursul istoriei, v-am discriminat, maltratat, sau v-am privit într-o manieră greșită, cu privirea lui Cain și when nu we have discriminated, mistreated, și nu am știut să vă recunoaștem, să vă prețuim și să vă apărăm pe cetățitatea voastră. Pentru Cain nu contează fratele său. Prin indiferență alimentăm prejudecăți și instigăm la ură. De câte ori nu judecăm în mod nechipzuit, folosind cuvinte care rănesc, cu atitudini care seamănă ură și creează distanțe. Când cineva este lăsat în urmă, familia umană nu mai merge înainte. Nu suntem creștini pe deplin și nici măcar umani, dacă nu știm să vedem persoana înainte de acțiunile sale, înainte de judecățile și prejudecățile noastre.
Sempre nella storia dell'umanità,
the history of humanity, there's always been Abel and Cain. There is the hand held out and the hand raised to strike. There is the open door of encounter and the door closed of conflict. There is one who sees a brother and one who sees an obstacle. There are those who see instead an obstacle standing in their way. There is the civilization of love and the civilization of hate. Each day we have to choose between Abel and Cain, like a person standing at crossroads. We are faced with a decisive choice, to go to the way of reconciliation or the way of vengeance. Let us choose the way of Jesus. It is a way that demands effort, but the way that brings peace and passes through forgiveness. May we not let ourselves be dragged along by the hurts we nurse within us. Let there be no room for anger, for one evil never corrects another evil. No vendetta ever satisfies an injustice. No resentment is ever good for the heart, and no rejection will ever bring us closer to others.
Există deschidere la întâlnire și închidere din cauza conflictelor. Există primire și există excludere. Există acela care vede în celălalt un frate și cel care îl vede ca o piedică pe drumul său. Există civilizația iubirii și există civilizația urii. În fiecare zi trebuie să alegem între a fi Abel sau Cain. Ca în fața unei răscruci de drumuri, suntem chemați să facem o alegere decisivă. Să parcurgem calea împăcării sau cea a răzbunării. Să alegem calea lui Isus. Este o cale mai istovitoare, dar este calea care conduce la pace și ea trece prin iertare. Să nu ne lăsăm duși de valul răutăților care ne macină înăuntrul nostru, fără ranchiună, deoarece niciun rău nu îndreaptă un alt rău. Nici o răzbunare nu dă satisfacție nedreptății, niciun resentiment nu face bine inimii, nici o închidere în sine nu apropie.
Dear brothers and sisters, you as a people have a great role to play. Do not be afraid to share and offer the distinctive gifts that you possess, that have marked your history and journey. We need these gifts, respect for the value of life and of the extended family, solidarity, hospitality, helpfulness, support, and concern for the vulnerable within your community. Respect and appreciation for the elderly. This is the great value that you have. The sense of religious meaning of life, spontaneity, and enjoy the vivere. Wherever you find yourself, share these gifts and try to accept all the good that others can offer you. For this reason, I would like to encourage you to journey together. There where you are, wherever you are, in helping to build a more humane world, overcoming fear and suspicion, breaking down the barriers that separate us from others, and encouraging mutual trust and the patient and never fruitless search for fraternity. Keep trying to journey together with dignity, the dignity of the family, the dignity of earning your daily bread. This is what helps you to go forward, and the dignity of prayer. Keep looking for the future.
Voi, ca popor, aveți un rol de protagoniști pe care să vi-l asumați. Nu trebuie să vă fie frică să împărtășiți și să oferiți acele caracteristici specifice vouă care vă definesc, care marchează drumul vostru și de care avem atât de mare nevoie. Valoarea vieții și a familiei, în sens larg, solidaritatea, ospitalitatea, ajutorul, sprijinul și apărarea celor mai slabi din comunitate, valorizarea și respectul celor în vârstă, și aceasta este o mare valoare pe care voi o aveți. Simțul religios al vieții, spontaneitatea și bucuria de a trăi. Să nu privați societatea în care vă aflați de aceste daruri, dar să fiți disponibili și să primiți toate acele lucruri bune pe care ceilalți vi le pot oferi și aduce. De aceea doresc să vă invit să mergem împreună, acolo unde sunteți, în construirea unei lumi mai umane, trecând peste temeri și suspiciuni, lăsând să cadă barierele care ne despart pe unii de alții, alimentând încrederea reciprocă în căutarea răbdătoare și nici când zadarnică a fraternității. Să ne angajăm să mergem împreună cu demnitate, demnitatea familiei, demnitatea de a ne câștiga pâinea cea de toate zilele, aceasta te face să mergi mai departe, și demnitatea rugăciunii, mereu privind înainte.
Questo incontro è l'ultimo
della mia visita. Is the last of my visit to Romania. I came to this beautiful and welcoming country. I came as a pilgrim and a brother, in order to meet all its people. I have met you. I have met many people to make a bridge between my heart and yours. Now I'm returning home. I return enriched by the experience of different places and special moments, but above all, by your faces. Your faces will color my memories and populate my prayers. I thank you. I carry you with me. And now I'll bless you, but before I ask you a great favor. Please pray for me. Thank you.
Aceasta este ultima întâlnire din cadrul vizitei mele în România. Am venit în această
very brief but very touching message of Pope Francis here,
pentru a trei diferite întâlniri.
Visiting this community of Roma.
Am întâlnit multe lume, pentru a crea punți între inima mea și a voastră.
Said, my heart, however, is weighed down by the many experiences of discrimination, segregation, and mistreatment experienced by your community. I ask forgiveness in the name of the Church and of the Lord, and I ask forgiveness of you. The Holy Father has also challenged the Roma community, wherever you find yourselves, share those gifts and try to accept all that others can offer you. And he says he returns to Rome, carrying the many experiences and faces of the people he has met here in Romania. The Holy Father will now give a blessing. The Our Father being recited by this small Roma community. In what the priest called the periphery of peripheries. The Our Father, just being recited by the community here. Now I give you my blessing.
And I would
like to bless your families, your friends, all the people
și vreau să binecuvântez
you know,
întreaga voastră familie, pe toți prietenii, toți cei pe care voi îi cunoașteți.
Benedica Dio Omnipotent,
Father also bless us.
Padre, Figlio, lo Spirito Santo.
Amen.
A presto.
We'll see each other soon. Very brief and touching, short visit. Outside, a choir of children. This was the last event of Pope Francis, who has been on a visit to Romania. The Holy Father is now going to return to Rome. It has been a very busy weekend for him. Many, many engagements. The children are having a great time indeed, as the Holy Father takes his leave of this community, in fact takes leave of Bulgaria. He has been on his 30th apostolic voyage. As the Holy Father is taking leave of this community, in effect, that also concludes our broadcast of Pope Francis's apostolic voyage to Romania. My name is Father Paul Samasumo. I would like, in a very special way, to thank CBS News, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, EWTN, Net TV, and Catholic TV. Thank you to all of you who took time to follow the Holy Father through the various Vatican media channels, the Vatican News web portal, Vatican Radio, Vatican News YouTube channel. Then, of course, those of us who followed us, those of you who followed us through the various radio stations of the world, as well as through the various internet sources. On behalf of everyone here at Vatican News, Laudato Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ.
Deve